doesn't. I'm kind of biased. But where are you guys from? Like, so this is Dublin Castle. Pretty castly, isn't it? There's one kind of castle bit over there, which we'll have a look at in a minute. The place was built in 1204 on the orders of King John of England. He usually plays the bad guys in Robin Hood movies. But a lot of it was destroyed in a fire in 1684, and that's why what you see today is mostly rebuilt in the Georgian style. Now, if you look to me, is it over here? This one is important to use the lion, not life-size lion, and this one over here is justice. There's nothing wrong with justice, I don't know if anybody can point out to me. Exactly, yeah, and she's not blindfolded, which is not partial. And she's also with her back to the people of Dublin, which is not appreciated very much at the time. And also, if you look at the scale she's holding, one is directly under her arm and the other one is not. So whenever it rained in Ireland, not very often, but like the very odd time it would rain, the rain would collect in the non-protected scales, if you like, whereas it would be the other scale was protected by her arm, and so the scale would tilt like that, which Dubliners thought was very symbolic of British justice. They realised it was happening and they drilled holes under the scales to kind of let the water out, but then the damage was done. People would see the symbol. And behind me is the guardhouse, which is used to house the crown jewels. The crown jewels are not just a sort of crown, but there were medallions and pendants with rubies and emeralds and diamonds, and you know, they're nice stuff. And in 1907, there was a visit of Edward VII to Ireland. And 4 days before the visit, and people are getting everything ready, sprucing things up. And somebody points out that the safe that the crown jewels are in is really a little bit shabby. So they decide to order a new one. So they order a new one, and it's sturdy and it's strong, it's perfect, exactly what they need. Except it doesn't fit in the door. They can't get into the room. So everybody's freaking out, and and everybody's panicking. Except the guy in the corner, a guard on duty actually, watching the whole thing. He gets up and he says, "No, I have an office upstairs with a key, and I have a drawer in this office also with a key. We're locked. It's in lock. Two locks. That's way better than a safe." And so he says, "Give the jewels to me. I'll mine them overnight, and I'll be fine." And so everybody kind of looks at each other, and they think, "Really good idea, don't you think?" So they give the jewels to this guy, and he puts them away for the evening. And the next morning they come back, and they ask him where they are, and he says, "I'm sorry, they kind of got an eight vanished." And he says, "I actually forgot that 10 other people have the key to that lock. So sorry about that." And they never found after this day. He got blamed for it. And they even burned, his house even burned down in 1921, but they're still a good man. So keep your eyes open, you know, and if someone calls out, okay, all right, so we're going to make our way over to the more castle built around here.